For more on this, let's bring in New York Republican Congresswoman Nicole Malliotakis. Congresswoman, good to see you. So initially, Nancy Pelosi seemed to have taken Ilhan Omar to the woodshed in a joint statement with Steny Hoyer saying, quote, drawing false equivalencies between democracies like the U.S. and Israel and groups that engage in terrorism like Hamas and the Taliban foments prejudice and undermines progress toward a future of peace and security for all. But earlier today, she said this. Listen here.
I think that she clarified her remarks, and that was we accept that. And she has a point that she wanted to make, and she has a right to make that point. There was some unease about how it was interpreted. She made her clarification.
So the Speaker of the House is saying, okay, that's it for that. Move on to the next thing. Nothing to see here. Is that good enough for you?
You know, how many times are we going to go through this? Ilhan Omar has not just done this once or twice. She has repeatedly made anti-Semitic comments, anti-Israel comments, anti-American comments, you know, to diminish what occurred on September 11th, to then go ahead and compare U.S. military, our nation, to terrorist organizations. I mean, this is completely outrageous, and my colleagues and I are vociferously calling for her to be removed from the House Foreign Affairs Committee. She is a liability to that committee. Think about, you know, when I went to Israel in 2019 and I spoke with citizens there, they for the first time felt the United States was wavering in its support for Israel because of members like Ilhan Omar and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. You know, this is enough already. She should be removed. She's a liability to the committee, and she's a liability to the United States of America. Having her in Congress, I think, is very detrimental and for our nation. And it's very unfortunate because, you know, she came to this country as a refugee, just like my mother did from Cuba. She should have a profound appreciation for the opportunity that this nation has given her, that she could rise to become a United States member of Congress. But unfortunately, she repeatedly badmouths our nation, and she does it publicly, and is not somebody who should be on the Foreign Affairs Committee representing our nation to other nations.
Well, what does that say about her colleagues who have come to her defense, including Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who tweeted this, pretty sick and tired of the constant vilification, intentional mischaracterization, she writes, and public targeting of Ilhan Omar coming from our caucus. They have no concept for the danger they put her in by skipping private conversations and leaping to fueling targeted news cycles around her. So what does it say about them?
The problem is they love this attention. They say these controversial, hateful comments and then get upset when people call them out on it. They're the ones that are creating this attention on the squad. They're the ones that are making them targets by from individuals like myself who feel that now they need to be removed. And I just feel that we need more members to step up. And what about the double standard that we're seeing? How quick were they to put up a vote on one of our colleagues to remove from the Education Committee, but they won't hold that same standard with their own members? You know, I've been consistent in my criticism and also with my votes as it relates to these matters. Nancy Pelosi should put up a vote to censure her. Remember, a couple of years ago, they actually put down a watered-down resolution instead of actually a resolution condemning her comments specifically. So I believe that it's time that the Democrats stop the double standards and that Nancy Pelosi come out strong, remove her from the Foreign Affairs Committee, put a vote to censure her completely from the House. And I think that the voters in her district really need to understand what's at stake here from a domestic policy perspective and an international perspective too. Imagine you are a U.S. military service member or a veteran who has fought for freedom and liberty for this nation, and you have a United States member of Congress diminishing your service and trying to compare you to terrorist organizations, Hamas and Al-Qaeda, or Hamas and the other, Taliban.
Right. We should point out, Congresswoman, that you've sent a letter to the Speaker of the House and to Steny Hoyer as well, urging that they take some action. Looks unlikely like anything that is, like that is going to happen. You say that she is a liability to the Foreign Affairs Committee there in the House. There's also the potential that the type of speech that she engages in, as well as other members of the squad, will present a liability for Democrats in November of 2022. So ultimately, this could play to Republicans' advantage.
Absolutely. Any member who stays silent and refuses to speak out and condemn her, we're going to associate next year in this election. And I commend those Democratic members who have been brave enough to come out and speak the truth, to say that this is unacceptable. Enough is enough. To have a member of the House of Representatives who's continuously condemning not only those of Jewish faith, but our allies and our own country, the own country that she was elected to represent in the House. I mean, that to me, I think, speaks volumes more than anything. And anyone who's going to remain silent, just as my predecessor did, it's going to become a campaign issue in the next election.
To that point, what are the political implications for 2022? Do you see? Final seconds left.
Well, look, you know, we're going to continue to talk about how these individuals are not only allowing somebody to speak anti-Semitic tropes. We're also going to point out the fact that they refuse to support our police, that we put up a resolution just a couple of years ago saying that Congress condemns attempts to dismantle and abolish our police, and every single Democrat voted against that resolution. So this is exactly what is at stake here in our country for next year's election. And just people have to just understand that we cannot allow people like them to be in the majority anymore. They're, you know, the fact that these individuals are not just on the Foreign Affairs Committee, but they're also in the majority, having power is very problematic.
We got to run. We're out of time, but clearly a lot to talk about in the next 16 months and a lot of opportunity to have you back in the program. Congresswoman Malliotakis, good to talk to you. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next up, a new warning about